If you just got handed a tool called SmartSuite and you're not really sure what it's all about, you've come to the right place. Because in this video, we're going to be doing a breakdown about everything a new user needs to understand about SmartSuite. Now, this video is being updated for the year 2025, so make sure to watch till the end so that you see all of the key features, all of the key building blocks that SmartSuite makes available to you in the present day. So if learning more about SmartSuite and how to start using it as a beginner is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission here to help you unlock the full potential of your no-code tools. And one of our favorite no-code tools is SmartSuite. SmartSuite has come a long way in a very short amount of time and they have a very powerful platform going into 2025. So if you're a brand new SmartSuite user, you're in good hands. There's a lot of key functionality that you're going to get once you understand what this tool does. Now, before we get into the heart of this video, I first want to invite you to join me for some training. If you're new to no-code tools like SmartSuite, you are going to love this free automation training. It's going to teach you how to start reclaiming your time by automating those repetitive, mundane tasks that you do every day. This is all possible with no-code tools like SmartSuite, and I'm going to teach you the building blocks of automation in the training. Sign up at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. You'll get immediate access there. But without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen here. I am in my SmartSuite dashboard. I encourage you to follow along with me. Open up SmartSuite in your web browser. If you're not already a SmartSuite user, sign up using our affiliate link that I'll share with this video. So now here I am. I'm inside of my SmartSuite dashboard. The first thing I need to understand is, what is SmartSuite? Well, it's a no-code tool that allows us to build solutions. No-code is this area of software right now that means you don't have to know how to code anything. You don't need to write a single line of code in order to build your own custom apps and tools. So it's a no-code software that allows you to build your own custom solutions to manage your business, your workflow, your process, etc. Now, not just you can also share those database solutions with other people. So once you've built these tools inside of SmartSuite, share them with other members on your team, maybe external users. Anyone that needs to see the information that you have in your SmartSuite database solution, well, you can share it with them. Now, inside of SmartSuite, each one of these icons, here I am on the SmartSuite homepage inside of my account. Each of these icons is its own solution. And solutions can start talking to each other. You can actually link them across so that all of your information is interconnected throughout your entire organization. So this is one of the most powerful features of SmartSuite that we're going to go into more detail on towards the end of the video. Now, there are three what I consider to be the core components of SmartSuite. Let's go ahead and dive into these one at a time. Now let's jump into one of our solutions to take a look at these different components. I'm gonna do a quick search for my sales CRM, and here it is. I'm just gonna select this icon, and this is opening up my sales CRM solution. Now the first thing to understand about SmartSuite is the data layer. The data layer is where we store all of our information. So here I am in my sales CRM. You see that at the top. Underneath that, we have what are called tables. Each table is effectively a list of information. So this particular list is a list of my opportunities. And on that list, I can add extra information like what's the value of each of these opportunities? How likely is it to close? What's the close date? What's the contract value? Et cetera, et cetera. So each one of these tabs up here, again, we call these each tables, but each of them has its own list of information. And all of these different lists, from accounts all the way to region, are all being shared in my sales CRM because they all have to do with the same type of information. It's all part of one solution. Now, the exciting part about SmartSuite is it's able to reach through these different lists so your data can talk across lists. So for example, here we see that we have a link to sales assets. So this is a link to a table called sales resources, which is this table right here. And this information in my opportunities table is connected to those sales assets. And so this partner program here that we see is actually a record inside of a different layer of our data or a different list, a different table in this solution. So here, partner program summary, this is a record that lives in the sales resources. And if we click into our sales resources, we are going to be able to find the partner program summary right here in the list. So you can see that these two pieces of information, they're linked together, they're talking. And so this allows us to perform a lot of calculations and connect data better than just a simple spreadsheet would do. Now, the second layer of SmartSuite is the automation component. We talked about this earlier at the beginning of the video when I invited you to the automation training. But inside of SmartSuite, we can build automated processes that perform in the background. Now, in order to access automations, you'll need to click on your solution here and come on down to automations, which is about halfway down the list. And inside of automations, you're going to see, now bear in mind, this is a demo account, but we can build processes that happen on some sort of automated schedule or based on some other automation trigger. In this particular case, we have an automation that says at a particular time, I'm going to find records that are in the opportunities table, and then I'm going to update all of those records. Well, we had another automation as well that says find sales manager. And in this one, similarly, when a record is updated, so a record over here meets certain conditions, well, when that happens, then we're going to find a record in sales managers and update that record. So as you can see, we can build automations that run in the background, keeping our data current and making it so that we don't have to manually update all of our information. Instead, it's going to flow through some sort of process so that when things happen within our organization, within our procedures, then naturally, the next steps will fall into place. This is going to help you stay on top of your work, stay way more organized, and save a ton of time. Now, the third key component of SmartSuite is understanding one of their newer features, which is dashboards. So inside of dashboards, it's actually its own view type. So here you can see I am in what is called a grid view, meaning that all the data we see is in rows and columns. But there are many other types of views. So here, for example, is a Kanban view, where it's the same data in the same sales resources list, but we're just displaying it differently. Well, the newest and most exciting view type is dashboards. So unique, in fact, that I think that it requires its own like layer, its own key factor, which is why we're calling it out in this video. To build a dashboard, simply come down here to create a view and select a dashboard from the list. And when you create this view, you'll be able to bring in different elements and drop them into your dashboard. So very simply, we come up here to add widgets. We can add static data, meaning it's the same every time. Or in addition to that, we can add some dynamic data. So we can actually bring in information from our database. So we can bring in things like a record display. So here's a place where we can make a selection of a record. And then when we select a record from this list, let's go ahead and add this component here. Well, then we can display other information off to the side. So maybe we want to display whatever record is selected here. So we can do a record display or record details here. And we will link it to the source, that previous widget that we just built. So that when we add this widget, let's actually set up some fields in it first. We'll bring in the asset name, we'll bring in the date published, and we'll bring in, let's say, a short description. We'll add this widget now, and when we select a different item from the list here, this information is going to be updated. So this dashboard component, this third component of SmartSuite, allows you to build a really flexible way to share information with the people on your team, allowing them to see exactly what you need them to see when you need them to see it. Now that we've talked about the key components of SmartSuite, let's focus on the three differentiating factors. These are the three things that I think sets SmartSuite apart from its competition. This is what SmartSuite does exceptionally well. Number one comes down to user permissions. SmartSuite is best in class when it comes to user permissions. In order to access that, we're going to go into this and access permissions from the solution level. And you can see that when we are sharing access to this solution, we can share it with all of the members on our team. We can share it only with specific teams, and we can go into advanced permissions, which allow us to add specific members from our team. And when we are making that addition, we can choose what level of access each user gets. So are they going to have full-blown access to everything in this solution? Or can they just edit and create their own content? Or can they only be a contributor where essentially they can only see stuff that they've been assigned to? Yeah, so there are a number of different ways that we can grant access here and lock down what people can do or can't do to the data that we've shared with them. Now, in addition to permissions at the solution level, remember, solution is sharing all of these different tables. Well, we can also access permissions at a table level. So down at the table level, we can select it, go into permissions here, and get even more granular. What are we allowing people to see? Are we removing certain fields from their view? Are we removing certain records from their view? SmartSuite is best in class when it comes to permissions. So when you're sharing solutions, pay a lot of attention to not only who you're sharing with, but also what level of access are you actually granting the different users in your SmartSuite account. Now, the second key feature that SmartSuite has that really sets it apart, in my opinion, is the My Work section. You can find the My Work section at the top of your screen up here. It's the checkbox. And this is a demo account, so bear with me. But inside of this, all of the different solutions that you have in SmartSuite are going to roll your personal tasks up to this place. So if you have tasks across multiple solutions, let's say you have tasks in your finance department database, and you have tasks over in your marketing database. Well, as work is assigned to you, you're gonna have it all consolidated right here. So you can see here, we've got marketing campaigns, and I can actually update the status of these different things. And as they're marked complete, they're gonna be removed from my checklist. But more importantly, it's also updating the data back in the solution. So this is one of those amazing features of SmartSuite, consolidating all of your tasks that you've been assigned into one place. This is something that the competition simply doesn't have, and it's going to make your life way easier when you leverage the power of My Work. Now, the last key feature that I think really needs to be highlighted that really helps differentiate SmartSuite, it's email functionality. So let's take a look at any one of these records. In fact, I'm gonna drill into a fake contact here. Now, bear in mind, this is fake data, but I'm gonna open up a contact. Let's open up Paul here by clicking here. This is opening up the record that is Paul Pellegrino. You can see all the information here displayed nicely. But what I want to draw your attention to is the communications center. We're going to go up into the upper right corner and click Add View Comments. This opens up the communications center on the right hand panel. Well, the exciting part about this is we can actually send emails from this place. In order to do that, we need to go into settings and we will toggle on emails. It's going to be off by default. Now, once we've made that change, we can now see the additional tab here. Inside of the communication center, we see comments next to emails. Now we can actually email right here and it's gonna connect with our actual email account. So you can see it automatically loaded my Gmail address here and I can choose a recipient. And the best part is these recipients can be right here inside of the record. So this particular record, you can see Paul has this, you know, again, example email address here. Well, I can just select it right here, leave him an email. I can send that email. It's gonna actually send from my Gmail account, and I'm going to be able to track it not only in Gmail, but also it's gonna be added right here to this record. So I'm gonna have a thread of all the communication I have with Paul over time, which is really helpful if I'm collaborating with a team and they need to know what I've already discussed with Paul. So these are some of those high-level key features that really set SmartSuite apart in 2025. And if I know SmartSuite, I wouldn't be surprised if they launch a bunch of new features that continues to propel this tool into 2026 and beyond. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. And if you did, of course, give us a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. And if there were questions that we didn't answer here, you need a little bit of help, I encourage you to swing by our website and look at the different resources we have. Of course, the most important thing out of all of this is for you to keep on building.